Hello, I'm Michał, and this is second part of my world generation tutorial. If you haven't watched the first part, make sure to do it now. Link will be in the description. Now let's set the height of our biomes. I will leave oceans flat, but you can try creating something in form of waves if you want. We will make grasslands, deserts, and snow biomes have small hills all over them. And lastly, we will make mountains and mesas be highly elevated. To do this, let's go back to our world gen script, create an integer and call it the default chunks. Int default chunks. There we go. This integer will be used to store amounts of default chunks in our scene. Then create a bool and call it do once. Bool do once. This bool will be used to set height of each chunk only once. Now go into void update and type in if do once is equal to false. Then default chunks is equal to game object dot find game objects with tag default dot length. This piece of code will check how many default chunks there are. Now underneath that create another if statement. If default chunks are equal to 0 and do once is equal to false, then now this if statement will be activated when all the chunks have their own biome, so there are no default chunks. Each chunk generated its own biome, so now we can generate its height. And the ones is e equal to false, so we have not set it the height yet, but we are about to do that. So now inside of this if statement, write game object dot get component box collider dot is trigger equals false. Now right now all the chunks have set the trigger as true, but we don't need them to be a trigger right now. We don't need them to be trigger anymore, so we're just gonna set it to false. Now, underneath that, we're gonna make another if statement, and we're gonna say that if game object dot tag is equal to grassland, or grassland or game object dot tag is equal to snow or game object dot tag is equal to desert. There we go. Now this if statement will be only activated if the chunks biome is grassland or snow or desert. So we can set the height for all of them at once because we want them to have a similar height. So to do that, we're gonna say vector 3. Okay. Scale, we're gonna call it scale. And we are going to make it equal to transform dot local scale And then we are going to write underneath that scale dot y equals random dot range, and here you write the height you want the biome to be. So I want grassland, snow biome, and desert to have a shallow hills, not some giant mountains. So my height is going to be small, something within the lines of 0.1 and 1. So not that big. And we are going to transform the game object. So game object dot transform dot local scale is equal to scale. So those three lines of code make the chunk have a different height. So now grassland, snow, deserts, we have a height between 0.1 and 1. So there's going to be a bunch of hills there. Now let's make something similar for mountains and mesa. So we are going to say if game object dot not transform dot tag, okay, is equal to mountains, or game object dot tag is equal to mesa. And yeah, so now we're going to set the height for mountains and mesa. It's of course going to be bigger than the grasslands, snow, and desert. So let's just copy that. Control C, and here we're gonna do Control V. And let's set that to 2 and 3. There we go. And now, of course, you can use it for your own biomes if you have created them. If you want to have some ginormous mountains, just make sure that those numbers here are bigger, and if you want something smaller, make sure they are smaller. If you want your biomes to have some really spiky terrain with completely random size, then make those numbers, the difference between those two numbers, bigger. I mean, it really depends on what you are trying to accomplish. And underneath those if statements, we're just gonna say do once is equal to true. So now this process is going to do itself only once, and then it will stop. Yeah, so because if you didn't do that, then the size of the chunks will be constantly changing, which we do not want. And now let's save that, and let's see what will happen in Unity. Okay, we go, we have Unity opened, and let's see if our sizes change. And there you have it. Now, as you can see, the grasslands have and deserts have those small hills all over them. The mountains and the mesas are highly elevated, and oceans, the water is flat, as it's supposed to be. And now the last thing we have to do is generate structures on the map. Before we start placing structures on the map, we need to make them. You can easily make some in Blender and then export them into Unity. I made trees for grasslands, Pyramids for deserts and igloo for snow biome. When setting up those prefabs, create an empty game object. Call it, for example, tree holder. And then get the tree model and make it a child of the empty game object. Then make sure that empty game object is just on the bottom of the tree holder. So gonna move the tree just a little bit, real quick. And now the empty game object is at the bottom of the tree. Assign the tree again as a child of the empty game object. And now in the empty game object, we're gonna create a rigid body. We're gonna set the use gravity as true. And in constraints, we're gonna freeze all the rotations and positions except from the position Y. Position Y needs to be unticked. So make sure you do that. And then in the tree model, we are going to use the box collider. Now, if the structure is the same size as the chunk, so for example pyramid, make sure that you make the box collider or any collider, make it just a little bit smaller, so it doesn't creep into the higher chunks next to, and basically that would cause an structure to float in the air, which we do not want. So make sure you make the hitbox smaller. And then once you've done with creating this, just make it into a prefab by dragging it to any folder you want. Lastly, go back to your WorldGen script and add integer and call it prefab spawn. That is going to be a chance of structure showing up on the chunk. Then create a bool here and call it end generation. This bool will be changed once all structures are loaded, and we don't need to do anything else with the script. And also add public game objects for all of your structures. So I'm going to write here public game object. We have a tree. Then we're gonna write public game object for pyramid. And lastly, we're gonna write public game object for igloo. There we go. Then, after you do that, you go to your update method here, and underneath what you wrote, here, just fix that. Here you need to write this script: if do once is equal to true, and generation is equal to false. So that if statement is gonna be activated once the height has for the biomes have been set, but the structures haven't been created yet. And here we're gonna use our integer prefab spawn, and Once again, we're gonna make a random number generator, so random dot range, and again, we're gonna do it with the percentages, so 1 to 100. And now, we're gonna do one of those if statements for each biome. So let's start with if game object dot tag is equal to grassland and prefab spawn is greater than 80. We are going to generate a tree. So game object tree. Right. And then we're gonna instantiate it. And we're gonna instantiate tree. Not this tree. That's my tree. No, we can't call it tree, let's call it something different. Let's just... I don't know, let's call it oak, but why not? And here we're gonna instantiate oak. No? Why is it not working? So... We want to instantiate. Oh, it's the wrong bracket, that's why. Oh no, that this can be tree again. So I apologize for that. My mistake. Oh yeah, now we've got it. So we want to instantiate a tree. Here we go. So now the tree is being created. And now we have to place it in our chunk. To place it in our chunk, we're gonna get the tree and we are going to transform dot parent to game object dot find and we are going to make it a parent of world holder and yeah, worldholder.transform. So now our tree is going to placed into the world holder game object. So we just gonna make our we just going to keep our hierarchy clean. That's all it's going to do. And then we are going to say that tree dot transform dot position to game object dot transform dot position. So now the tree is going to set its position to our chunk's position. That's what's happening in this line. And lastly, what we want to do is we're gonna say tree dot transform dot position is equal to new vector free transform dot position dot x and comma two comma transform dot position dot z. Here we go. And now that code is going to make it archy a little bit above the chunk. You might want to set the y coordinates here to the number bigger than what's the max size of max height of the chunk. So make sure you do that. And while we're doing this, if we will not do that, then the structure will generate inside of the chunk, and it would look ugly, and but we want our structure to be on top of the chunk. We don't want the tree to be underground. That's why we need this, and that's also why we need rigid body. So once we move that position into move the tree into that position, the tree is going to fall and land exactly on our in the middle of our chunk. So yeah, that's how it works, and we can do that for all the other biomes. So now there's a 20% chance that the tree is going to be on the grassland. You can make it higher, you can make it lower, depends on what you want. I want, now let's do deserts, and deserts will generate pyramids. I don't want the percentage of pyramids be so high, so I'm just gonna write 95 here, make it a bit more rarer. We are going to make a pyramid. Do you want to instantiate pyramid, right? So we're gonna do this here. There we go. Just remove all the trees and place pyramids in there. That's what I'm doing right now. Okay. Spell that incorrectly. Yeah, I did. Well, whatever. Yeah, so that's going to do the same thing, just with pyramids. And let's just copy that once again and do the same for igloo. So if the biome is snow, so snow biome, the percentage, let's say it's the same as the pyramids. And we want to instantiate an igloo here. So once again, I'm just changing all those names to the correct ones. There we go. And now our generation, our structure generation is complete. So let's save that. Let's go back to Unity. And okay. And now we need to set the structures. Spawn, so need to set the structures in the editor. So do that for every chunk. Okay, I'm back, and as you can see, all the prefabs, all the game objects have been set in the editor. So now when we run our game, structures should spawn on the map. So let's see if that works. Oh, that's not exactly what we want. I know why this is happening. What we forgot, right after that, we want to end generation. Let's set it to true. So we stopped generating structures. We don't need any more structures. So yeah, so let's do that. And now it should work. It would hopefully work again. Well, no. Let's see that. Oh, it almost crashed my computer then. And as you can see, we have trees in the grasslands. All of them are in their correct positions. We have eagles over here. And see if we can find some pyramids. Doesn't seem like it. Let's see why. Go back to our code. And have I called the tag correctly? You need to make sure that you called your tag correctly. And I say deserts, except from deserts. So always make sure that you have the correct tags. Okay, now it should work. Now it should hopefully all be working fine. And I think I see a pyramid. Yeah, there's a pyramid. There's some trees, some more pyramids. We have some eagles over here. Our world generation is done. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something. Make sure to like and subscribe for more tutorials. I'm also making devlogs on my major project, and from time to time I'm joining a game jam. I'm sure you will enjoy my content. But for now, bye bye.